Greetings, one and all. I'm just walking around Kit Kat, who's sitting right at my chair. So, hello everyone. Hello everyone. Kit Kat. Oh, he's gone quiet now. Alright then. So, here we are at the final day for this piece. And the final session. Right, let me take stock of what's going on here. Okay, and I shall need to work at the top, so I am going to just take out the couple of colors that I require for this piece in that area. Okay, that one. Right, we've got a range of colors now that I want to use. I can shift that down to there, and then I can reasonably adequately work at the top there. And excuse my shirt riding up my butt, my back rather. Anyway, righty-ho then, folks. Let's hit it. And it's nothing more than a hint, really. This colors that I'm going to be putting in here. Nothing more than an int. What is an int? There's also another color. Where are you? That one. Yes, it's that one. And there's also that one, actually, come to think of it. And that one as well, maybe. I don't know. I'm actually going to be more suggesting at the foliage and what have you here. Rather than trying to depict specific plants and trees and what have you. It's just to kind of get some colour going in this area. Oopsie. Oh, I haven't got anything on. On the... Damn. I do need something to keep it up, of course. Taking all my... All the clamps off. Both clamps off. Goodness. Well, no. Let's put that down there. As well. Just to keep that from toppling over. No. Literally doodling once again. I haven't got, you can't get the accuracy required with a pestle or any other of the tools or mediums that I use to depict individual leaves as such. So just kind of just hinting at these, the sunlight finding its way through the canopy above. into the surrounding foliage, etc. Just want to bring that yellowy light subtly into the top edge of the top side of the waterfall as well. I'll then be going over this with acrylic, but just as an underlying colour just there, and of course some of it also. Let's just finish that properly there before I forget. Sure, I had a darker green than that. Maybe I don't. Perhaps I'm imagining things once more. Let's get that back up there and have a little squiz. Yeah, I don't think I do actually. Nah. Let's just use that though. I'll be there. Interesting. We'll use that one and that one. Alright, we've got a range of more than enough colours there. Alright, so let's just also get one of our charcoals out. Right, now we're set. Now we are set. It's not these kind of little squiggly lines, little doodles here and there. More of an illusion of trees and foliage and what have you than anything else. Oh, come on. Now, just a little bit of blending with my eraser. Can't get to the end of the edge of the page. Gonna have a nervous breakdown. So obviously there's loads of ferns and some trees and all that, all surrounding this. Some of the trees are growing out of the, from in between the rocks, etc., etc., etc. So with about 5 or 6 different colours and hues, Huey Lewis in the news, employed here, we get this nice semblance of depth of field, depth of colour, depth of contrast. And also subtlety. And perhaps I need to be a little bit more, have a little bit more yellow on here, because I'm going to go over this with acrylic. So I want that.